Hello and welcome, I'm Nemesis6001, and today I'm going to play some Deus Ex Mankind Divided. This is the first Deus Ex game I will have ever played, and I've heard some pretty good things about it, so let's jump right in. We're going to new game it. Play games for their story and experience. So is this the difficulty? Seems to be. Let's do it. Let's do that. Okay, so there's a recap video of this, which I have, you know, dabbled into. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to film it. I'm not going to say anything. I'll just kind of, or will I say something? I don't know. We'll see. Let's find out.
It was 2027. Advances in biotechnology were helping people improve their physical and mental abilities to an amazing degree. Provided, of course, they had enough money. A new breed of people was emerging, half human, half machine. And in Detroit, at least, not everyone was happy to see it. I'd just landed a job as head of security at Seraf Industries, a cutting-edge biotech firm. David Seraf himself handpicked me for the job, said he needed me to keep his people safe. My ex, Megan Reed, was one of them. Brilliant neuroscientist, Megan had found a way to make augmentations safe and affordable for everyone. All she had to do was present her research to Congress. But the night before her big meeting, my security measures failed. A team of Black Op mercenaries stormed into Seraf headquarters, massacring everyone in sight. Three of the mercs were heavily augmented walking tanks. Their mission? Take out Megan and her team. I tried to stop them, but their leader tossed me through a plate glass wall. Last thing I heard as his bullets slammed into my brain was Megan's dying scream. I should have died with her. Only I didn't. High-end, military-grade enhancements saved my life. The best augmentation Seraf's money could buy. It took me half a year to get a feel for her. Should have taken longer. But 6 months into my recovery, Seraf Industries was attacked again. This time, by a radical group of pro-human purists. Violent, militant, and fanatically opposed to human augmentation. They claimed to be members of Humanity Front, a non-profit organization that wanted the UN to limit biotechnology research. The thugs broke into Seraf's factory and found machinists working overtime on a top-secret military augment called the Typhoon. Seraf sent me to retrieve it, and when I did, I found one of the so-called purists next to it, wired with cerebral implants, trying to download its classified specs. Obviously, something more was going on. The Aug killed himself before I could question him. Seraf ordered me to dig deeper. So with the help of Frank Pritchard, Seraf's head of cybersecurity, I did. Turns out a second hacker had been controlling the Aug's actions from somewhere off-site. Pritchard and I tracked his signal to a secret FEMA internment camp in Detroit. The Black Op mercenaries were there. The same mercs who'd left me for dead 6 months before. Figured they'd try again when they saw me. Wasn't so easy for them this time. I took out the tank named Barrett. Even got him to give me a new lead. A penthouse apartment in China. Of course, we both knew it would be a trap in the end. Hengxia Island, China. Home to a city so crowded, they had to build a second city on top of it. Trying to find clues in Hengxia wouldn't be easy. Lucky for me, I wasn't alone. Farida Malik, Seraf Industries ace pilot, had lived in Hengxia before. A good person to have on your side. She knew enough about the place to get me around. Malik dropped me in the lower city, close to the penthouse Barrett had told me about. Bell Tower Associates, a private security firm under contract to the Chinese government, had agents tossing the suite when I arrived. Just not for the reason I'd been expecting. Turns out the man who lived there was a criminal hacker named Van Bruggen. The same hacker who'd been remotely controlling the Aug in Seraf's factory. Van Bruggen's panicked decision to force the man to commit suicide had been a mistake. Now his mercenary partners were gunning for him, and I needed to find him before they did. Locating Van Bruggen meant playing nice with the Triads, Hengsha's organized crime lords. They had the hacker holed up inside a low-rent capsule hotel. By the time I found him, Van Bruggen had no qualms giving up the woman who hired him. Zhao Yunru, president of the Taiyang Medical Corporation. According to Van Bruggen, Zhao wanted to monopolize the augmentation industry and had hired Black Op mercenaries to destabilize her competition. Seraph Industries was at the top of her list. To prove this, I needed to get inside TYM and grab a surveillance hologram off a server. I suspected Van Bruggen was hiding something when he told me this, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. Megan wasn't dead. She and her four best researchers had been kidnapped, spirited away somewhere while their kidnappers made it look like they were dead. Desperate to learn more, I confronted Zhao in her penthouse. She claimed to be a pawn in a bigger plan and hinted at a group so powerful it controlled global interests at a whim. Then she slipped into a panic room and hit the alarm, forcing me to make a very quick exit. I figured Zhao was lying, but part of her confession made sense. David Seraph had been worried about his people. So worried, he'd required all of them to have subdermal locator devices surgically implanted. The GPLs would have been broadcasting the day of the attack. But Zhao sent a single call to Picus, the world's leader in global 24-hour satellite news, and turned those signals off. I needed to fly to Picus headquarters in Montreal if I wanted to learn more. Eliza Kassan, Picus Communications' First Lady of News. Malik thought I was reaching when I told her Eliza was involved in this. The world's most famous news anchor, working with a mercenary hit squad. But when I confronted Kassan in her office, she freely admitted to jamming Detroit satellites the night Megan's team had been taken. Said she's just been following her commands. I suspected she wanted to say more. But Black Op mercenaries showed up, looking to shut us both down. And just like that, the Eliza I'd been talking to disappeared. The mercs were led by an augmented killer I'd crossed paths with twice before. Fedorova, a woman who'd made Silence her best friend. She waited for me to track Eliza's transmission to a secret server room underneath the Picus complex, then jumped me from behind. A deadly fight ensued. I made sure she never moved silently again. With Fedorova down and no one left to keep Eliza quiet, she reappeared. Turns out Picus's First Lady of News wasn't a lady at all. She was a sophisticated AI program, engineered to monitor data streams and control what people believed. Eliza told me the mercs had brought in a Humanity Front doctor named Isaiah Sandoval to remove the scientist's implanted tracking devices while Detroit's satellites were down. She also told me to speak to David Seraph if I wanted to learn more. By the time Malik and I got back to Detroit, tensions between normal and augmented citizens had reached a flashpoint. Riots were breaking out in several cities, and the UN was being urged to intervene. Seraph was trying hard to convince Hugh Darrow, the inventor turned philanthropist who'd once been a leading proponent of enhancement technologies, to help stop a possible regulatory vote. Seraph had a lot riding on Darrow. Megan's discovery would have given millions of people the chance to evolve beyond their normal human abilities, and at the same time, catapulted Seraph Industries to the top of the Fortune 500. According to Seraph, Megan's kidnappers knew this and didn't want people evolving unless they controlled how it was done. He called his enemies Illuminati and urged me to keep searching. Determined to do so, I tracked down Sandoval via America's most outspoken augmentation opponent, Bill Taggart, Sandoval's boss and founder of Humanity Front. Sandoval admitted to operating on Megan's team when I confronted him, but said he hadn't removed their GPLs. He'd merely switched them to a different frequency. Pritchard was able to trace one of the signals to China. Malik and I immediately took off in pursuit. Unfortunately, the Illuminati were one step ahead. ambushed. Shot out of the sky by Bell Tower associates, seconds after entering Anxious airspace. Malik's piloting skills saved me. After a tense and bitter struggle, I escaped into Lower Anxia. The tracking signal I was following led straight to the Triads, or more specifically, to the augmented arm of Tong Si-Hung, leader of a gang of augmentation harvesters. Tong said they'd taken the arm off a corpse, which Bell Tower had left at their door, meaning at least one of Seraph's scientists was dead. Maybe not the rest of them, though. Tong pointed me to a port used for human trafficking and helped me slip aboard a Bell Tower ship. It was sailing to Rifleman Bank Station, a military base in the South China Sea. Bell Tower was holding kidnapped civilians as prisoners there, and using them to perfect the Hiron Project, a human-computer interface that left most of its test subjects dead. My search for Megan would have ended then, if not for a mysterious ally named Quinn. In exchange for my help exposing Bell Tower, he slipped me aboard a second ship headed to Singapore and an Illuminati-run biotech facility called Omega Ranch. Three of Seraph's scientists were there, forced by their captors to create a technology capable of remotely shutting down augmented abilities. Thanks to an emergency recall notice issued by the World Health Organization, millions of people all over the world already had the biochip installed. With the help of the scientists, I tracked Megan to a private section of the ranch. There, I ran into Yaron Namir, the walking tank who'd put a bullet in my brain the first time we met. He'd teamed up with Zhao and was hoping to catch me off guard. Their little ambush didn't work. I found Megan in a suite belonging to Hugh Darrow, the billionaire philanthropist who Seraph had called on for help. Darrow had convinced her to go along with the biochip plan by promising to sabotage the tech. As she was explaining this, Darrow appeared in a global broadcast, telling the world that augmentations would be the death of mankind. Then he activated the biochips to prove his point. All over the world, augmented people flew into a killing frenzy. Darrow had betrayed everyone, and it was up to me to set things right. To do it, I had to reach Panchaea, a massive installation in the Arctic Ocean. As I raced through corridors built by an all-augmented workforce, I saw death and destruction firsthand. By the time I shut down Darrow's broadcast, I knew the damage he'd done. Still, humanity's future remained unclear. How would the world react to the sabotage? Would people ever regain their faith in augmentations again? What would be the Illuminati's next move? Only time will give us the answers.
Well, okay then. That was a nice little recap. Not many games do that. More games should definitely do that if there's a big series going on. Seems like the lore in this is fairly deep.
I once thought I could save the world. Now look at it.
In yet another augmented terror attack, 251 passengers aboard Sista Airlines Flight 451 were killed. When an augmented passenger broke into the plane's cockpit and ruthlessly butchered its flight crew.
Well, damn.
Details recovered from the black box recorder suggest that the man may have been suffering flashbacks to the AUG incident. That horrible day 2 years ago when augmented people all over the world flew into a psychotic killing spree, causing the greatest loss of life in recent history.
Huh. So we're 2 years
sometimes
from the last event.
You just have to let go and embrace what you've become.
Not gonna go all wonky on us now, Hansa, are ya?
Well, if I do, MacReady, I guarantee you'll never see it coming.
Agent Jensen, am I gonna have a problem with you?
No, sir. No reason to assume you would.
Good. Because you are the only augmented operative on this team. and I intend to make good use of you.
I ain't your toy, boy.
Listen up, all of you. We got a sandstorm barreling down our ass, and we can't afford to make mistakes. We're going after this man, an arms dealer named Shepard. He's ex-Bell Tower, one of the Special Forces commanders who disappeared during the incident.
And he's come out of hiding. That cannot be good.
It's not. He's selling weapons and military-grade augments to terrorists. This is Aran Singh, the undercover agent who lured Shepard out of his hole. Best you see Interpol's got. But 3 years he's worked hard to get in tight with the Jinn, an Iraqi smuggling cartel that's infected the Eastern Hemisphere like a plague. Last week, our arms dealer sent a message to the Jinn, offering to sell them a shitload of black market merchandise dirt cheap. They told Singh to handle the buy.
They're not gonna like it when Interpol disrupts their party. Is Singh's cover really that good?
It is right now. We need to keep it that way. This is where the deal's going down. A half-finished high-rise hotel that's been abandoned ever since the incident. It's not a pretty picture inside.
Let me guess. Most of the laborers were augmented with heavy-duty industrial rigs. So when the incident hit, and they all went schizo, things got gruesome real fast.
And no one, except for some homeless junkies, have been inside the place ever since.
So what's the plan, Director?
Singh's meeting Shepard on the ground floor, inside the hotel's main atrium. He sent the bulk of his Jinn crew to the penthouse levels to secure a vantage point. I want MacReady's team to take up positions overlooking the atrium and make the arrest. Jensen, you're going in solo from the roof.
My objectives?
Keep the Jinn from joining the party. As far as we can tell, only one route connects the atrium to the penthouse level, a halfway decent elevator shaft, here. I want you to block access to it.
Fine, just cut me loose.
Do you plan on relying solely on your augments for this one? I'd recommend taking a little hardware, just to be sure.
Ah, I get the choice. You see in there, it might be easier to maintain its cover if he's not the only one still breathing when this is done. I'm not leaving my sixth exposed. Give me something lethal. Okay.
We've got a UC in there. Might be easier to maintain his cover if he's not the only one still breathing when this is done.
Smart thinking.
Yeah, but if anything does happen to him, you'll be telling his wife. After you get out of the hospital, of course.
What about range? There's lots of wide spaces and high ceilings in there, but a number of tight and constrained rooms too.
So it's a crapshoot, really.
Ooh, okay. Do I have a tranquilizer rifle or a short range? Ooh, what do I want to go for? Okay.
Well, I'm not looking to play dice with anyone in there. Give me something with distance.
Your call. Less chance of being seen and compromising Singh that way. One last thing, Jensen. Singh said the Jinn are using some sort of portable Wi-Fi device to boost communications. He's got a better chance of maintaining cover if you disable it.
I'll keep an eye out for it. But aren't we on the clock here? You said there's a sandstorm moving in.
There is, and we got the intel on this mission at the very last minute. So we're scrambling a little. If it comes to it, your number one priority is keeping the Jinn out of that atrium.
Copy that.
Time to put away your heavy thoughts, gentlemen. We're approaching the target building.
You're up first, Jensen. Let's do this.
Banging. Let's go raid some bitches. So I got to block an elevator from what I remember. Didn't really explain what I'm doing. Or if it did, I didn't pay attention hard enough. But I was paying attention quite hard. But fuck it. I guess we'll find out in a minute. Alright, so I'm going in solo and these guys are going in from the bottom. Or the side. Oh damn. Well, that was majestic as fuck. I like it. Alright, got a rifle.
Meter, this is Jensen. I'm on the roof.
Solid copy. Move into the building. The access route you need to block is at the far end of the penthouses. And keep in mind, the direct route might not be the easiest one.
Roger that.
MacReady will advise once his team is on the ground. Miller out.
I feel this is very, very sensitive. How do... That's... Oh, outfits. Well, options... mouse sensitivity 31, fuck it. That's a bit better. Okay, I can drag a corpse around. Oh shit. Press the search. Ooh, what are you? Credit chip, okay. I'll take that. You're pretty fucked, ain't you? Okay, so he had like an augmented arm buzzsaw. That's. Oh, it's a foot. Okay. Rotate? Oh, okay. Shift to spin. Oh, sprint. Fucking, I thought it was talking about the, fucking thing. The bin. Okay, that's something new. Oh, cool. Let's go in here. Have you got anything? Just another credit chip. What are you? Don't know what you are. Well, got ourselves a buzzsaw. So, what are my things? What can I do? Okay, so that's obviously jump. Okay. I hope they're going to give me some more context because I've got nothing. Okay, that's the menu. We did just weapons? Okay. Alright, so this is what I've got. Obviously. Oh god, I don't know what any of this is. These look like augments of some sort. Oh damn. This game, this is in depth, alright. I like it. Where does it say? I don't know where it says price. I'll come back to that. It'll probably give me something. Alright, I don't have any bolts. Seal off access to the asylum secondary. Jam the signal booster. Can I select you to focus on you, or no? Okay. Triangle. Scan. So I have to get a phone app? Well, I guess I'll do that at some point. There we go. How to use triangle codes. Okay, so it's just some outside-y bits. Fair enough. Right, let's do this. What are you? Just that. Okay. Boom.
Jensen, we're moving through. Oh, fuck!
What's wrong?
The djinn have got a few Jennies up and running. Gonna have to hack keypads.
Should enjoy it, MacReady. They have colors and shapes. Just remember, red means bad.
Fuck you.
Boss. Okay, third person ladder climbing seems a little unnecessary to change the camera angle for that, but hey, I won't question it. Okay, what have we got here then? Whoop. Excuse me? I throw you off edge, yes? No? Come on now. There you go. That's nice. This water's pretty. I like it. I appear to be stuck. There we go. Right. Anything around here that's worth... Okay, that's just the thing. What about you? You're the other thing. Okay, I think we're all good. Okay. Nice and simple. Jumpy, jumps and runs. It's all good. Uh, B. Okay. So the augment will. F, really? The F keys are that? I'd rather it be the number keys, to be completely honest, but hey. Well, to equip smart vision, press the middle mouse button to access it. Okay, and then I use that to activate it. Okay. What have we got here? I don't think that was very sneaky, but fuck it. So what is this? Okay. Can I crawl through you, or...? Okay, well, there's people over there, so... That's a thing. How they didn't notice me punching through that wall is just beyond me. But I don't know how I did that, but okay. View? Do I have to hold it? Well, okay. Quick inventory. Well, okay, that makes sense. That's what I want. Which one's the hacker? Is that you, hacker? No, that's ammo. Rifle ammo. Yeah, put you there, I guess. Oh, I did a thing. Does it? Oh god, should have examined it. Okay. Right. Well, if I put like you there and then fucking you guys there, that'd be good. I need to get through you. How do I do it? Keypad disabled. I guess follow the wires. There's a thing in there. Let's go up here. Up and round. That is the way. Boop. Right. What we got here? Oh, hello. Oh, no. That ain't pretty. Shit, is this whole thing going to be electrocuted? No, it would appear not. It's fine. That seems to just be the water. Right. Let's have a gander at you, shall we? Security training. Let's hack it then, I guess. Oh my god, I don't know what this is. IO port. Okay. Did I do good? Press C to capture nodes. I'm pressing C. Nothing's happening. Oh, no. Help. Let's look at help. IO ports, your entry point system. I just cover it all. I discovered units for your goal. Okay, so I've got to get to the green thing. Okay. I'm pressing C, but nothing is happening. Okay, maybe I'll go up here. Okay, capture. Right, I get it.
Anomaly
boom.
Detected.
Oh, shit.
Trace program initiated.
How do I stop? Check the iPort boost user. I'm trying to get before time runs out. Okay, that should be okay. 4-5. Oh, all this does. Oh god. Okay. Capture.
Access granted.
Oh, okay. Okay. That seemed good. I don't really know what I was doing, but I did it. Right, I need to go sneaky because I'm pretty sure there's guards around. Yeah, there are. Tutorial mode, cover as possible. Right, follow the green holograms to receive tutorial. Okay, learn about moving, cover, swapping. Right, end tutorial mode, I guess? It's probably for the best. Right, move to the green hologram, press F to take cover. Okay, F is cover. Aim at the next hologram and press space to move to it. Okay, space. Boom. Hold a movement key in the direction of the green hologram, then press space to roll from the cover. Right, okay, so. Okay, well, that didn't really roll, but hey. Not that way, you Berkeley. What are you doing? Okay, aim at next cover, press space to vault over. That's simple enough if he would actually aim at it. Screw it, I'll just go for it. Okay, he didn't. He didn't do it. F. Alright, good enough. Aim at the hologram. Press space, run out of cover, and back into first person. Right. Tour complete. Do you want to exit or fucking? That's fine. Fine with me. Let's do this. My question is, can I aim? Yes, I can. Right. Who we got here then? He's walking away, so let's deal. Oh shit! Is this loud? It should have a silencer on, isn't it? Right. Popped. What can I do with you? Alright, let's search him. I will definitely take those. I didn't mean to do that. Let's drag him. Let's put you in there. Can I go in? Can I come over here? Yeah, they ain't gonna look from there, are they? Right, I'm fairly safe over here. Where is this bitch? There he is. Hello there, sunshine. Oh. Nothing on you, fair dues. You go to sleep now, boy. You ain't finding me. Just gonna move you over here. And also gonna take your shit. What have you got? You got some of that cool beans. Fuck me, I can bring you around, can't I? Okay. Who are you? Oh, bottle of goods. Anything around here? Can I detect anything with my eyes? That's through the other side, isn't it? Aha! The rooftops? Oh, that's where I am, I see. Rooftops is where I is at.
Mac, listen up. Doppler shows that sandstorm's moving in fast. It's big and it's...
I just want to pause.
Gonna hit us hard.
God, I hate the fucking desert. Confirm visual?
I can. Time is not on our side.
Copy that.
Solid copy.
Well, that's good. Tutorial mode. Green holograms. Right, enter tutorial mode. Let's do this. What are we doing? Press home to reset the tutorial end. Right, okay. F4. Oh, it's invisible. Ah. Oh wait, what did I do? Get out. How long does it last though? Hold the right mouse button while aiming at an NPC to use the LiDAR. So wait, what? Hold the right mouse button down while aiming. I don't understand. Okay. While aiming at an NPC. What one was the LiDAR? You? Nope. Okay. I don't think that's a thing I was meant to do. Ah, mate, you can't see me. What are you talking about? See? Sneaky stuff. Fuck it, I'll just end it there. I don't need don't need your shit. Well, let's start by going invisible. And then go over there. And... where do I want to go? Let's head over here. Ooh. This could be bad. I don't know how long this thing... Oh shit, it does have a battery. And it is dying very quickly. Right, let's turn you off then. B to open the quick menu. Right, okay. Holster weapon. Do I even have one? I would appear to. Oh, as in, like, right, that holster's the weapon. I see. I don't want to do that. Get my weapon out. There we go. Right, okay. Boom, invisible. Let's try. Also, what are you? Fuck it, I'll take a machine pistol. Detect. Oh dear. So a quick gander's round. Okay, there's a few people behind there. These guys don't seem to be coming at me, so that's fine. Right, sure, let's do this. V to open quick inventory. Press. I don't know what that's doing. Okay. Nope. Not a clue what that did. V, let's try it again. What? Screw it. And balls to it, we'll just go at them. I'll figure stuff out on the way. Oh shit. Alright, let's go invisible. And head over there. Who have we got around us? Alright, running out of juice here. Oh, titties. That is right in the testes.
I will not be baited.
Okay, he's heading back upstairs, so I should be able to go around here. And... Oh, shit. Why are you on fire? Oh, you have to cock it. That is not a good thing. Okay. Let's have a quick look up here. Oh, what are you? Are you something? Are you a thing? Nope, just a coffee mug. Okay, so you can make noise with like boxes and shit like that as well. And you also make noise when you stand up and run. Okay, oh, that's good to know. Right, sleep time you. I think I might balls this up, so let's go invisible again quickly. Okay, if I sit here. Have you noticed me? Alright, one of the bastards are down. And another one. Right, who we got down here then? Allies have joined.
Jensen, what's your 20?
Working my way through the penthouses.
Remember to keep an eye out for the Jin's communications booster. If you can, disable it.
Roger that.
Did I get that guy? I don't think I did. I'm fairly certain I got him that time though, Jesus. Well, fuck it. Guess this ain't working. Right, well, I hate to leave it on such a cliffhanger, but I'm going to save it there, and I'm going to end this recording. So I hope you guys have enjoyed these episodes, and I shall hopefully see you on the next ones. Goodbye.